Hello everyone, I'm Tanishka and today I'll be showing you how can you make a story time app in Code2Play. So we need to start a new project and I'm going to name it as Story Time. So what this app is that in this you can read ebooks. There are many apps that ask for money for ebooks, but in using this app you can read any story for free, and you just need a good internet connection for it. So here, before you start beginning, you need to go to your drive and you need to upload the stories that you want. So here I have uploaded three stories. It's the Lion and the Mouse, it's the little red hen, and the last story is the story of Hansel and Gretel. So these three stories are there in my drive. So now let's begin the part of in Code2Play. So first on the screen, what you require is a vertical arrangement that you will find when you scroll down in the layout section. You find a vertical arrangement, you put it, and then you change the width and the height to fill parent so that it covers the entire screen. And then on that, you from the user interface, you drag and drop two labels and a button, and then again clicking on vertical arrangement, you can just put it in the center so it looks good. And here in the label one, you need to rename as story time, and the second label you need to rename it as read stories. For free. You get it? And on the button, you scroll down and then you find text option, and in the text for this you write let's start, and then you can change some properties like the color and shape. So I change them. Here we go. I changed the color and size of the components on the screen. Now next, what you need to do is you can just click on this minus symbol you find here, and here this visible, you need to click on it so that it's not visible. This it doesn't go anywhere, you have it saved here. Then again you scroll to layout, and this time you don't need vertical arrangement, you need vertical scroll arrangement. And here again you change it to fill parent. Okay, so here we have it again on our entire screen. This time it's vertical scroll arrangements. So on this, the components you need to bring are three buttons. So again you go to the user interface, drag and drop three buttons. They'll be named as 2, 3, and 4 because the button one was the button for let's start. So here again you click on button two, and then here you change the name. So here I'll write it as story one. Then I click on the second button and I name it as story two. Then for the third one, the third button, which is named as button four here, is supposed to be named as story three. So we have here story one, two, and story three. So here you can change the height. So height I'll make it as 25%, and the width as fill parent, and the font size can be 40. You can also increase it if you wish to. Now you should do the same step for the other two. So here I have changed the properties of other things also. Here you have the vertical scroll arrangement with story 1, 2, 3, 4 written on them and the background. So now what we will do is we go to vertical arrangement 1 again and make it visible. And vertical scroll arrangement, you need not make it visible. So when you come here in this vertical, you need to click on the plus symbol. Here on button 1, you need to rename it. So I'll rename it as start button. So it won't affect the text on it. Just for a reference, we are renaming it. And so it's start button. So let's go to the blocks part first. So here first you need to click on start button. Here you need to take the option when start button click do, and then after that what should happen is it should open another screen. Sorry, not another screen. It should open. It should make the vertical scroll arrangement too visible. That's the vertical scroll arrangement is where we have put the options of story 1, 2, 3, 4 visible to true. So we take true from the logic drawer and then from the vertical arrangement we take the element to visible false. So this was the first piece of our code. Now let's do the second piece. But before that, what we need to do is we need to add more screens. So we move to the designer interface here. You go to add screen and you rename it as, in caps I'm writing it as story 1. So I put it as story 1. So here instead of 1 I put an exclamation, so it's story 1. And the screen takes some time to load and come up. So there you'll put the first story, but before that we'll be adding the story 2 screen. Story 2 screen, and you do the same and add the story 3 screen as well. So here I have added story 3 screen as well. So I have story 1, story 2 and story 3. It doesn't matter what the name is. So here you have it. And now we again go to move to the block interface. And here you have the buttons here. So when you scroll down over here, here you have the start button here, right? So here you can just open it up. On the vertical scroll arrangement, your button 2, 3, 4. So for no confusion, you can just move on to designer and make the vertical scroll arrangement 1 to non-visible and this 2 to visible so that you can see now this button 1, the button 2 can be renamed to story 1. And the remaining two to story 3 and 4 respectively. So here I have named them to story 1, 2 and 3. And we again move on to the blocks interface. That's the blocks part. So here you have one piece of code already done. Here you'll start the second piece. So when story 1 dot click, so the button's name is story 1. So when story 1 dot click, what should happen is it should open another screen. So you go to the control and then when you scroll down there, you find open another screen, screen name, you put it and you duplicate it and change it to story 1. In the first it should be story 1. In the second piece it should be story 2 and in the third piece it's supposed to be story 3, and then you need to drag and drop this text once, so you duplicate it again, this one also thrice, and you fill the name of the screen. Like for story 1, you can check this name, it shouldn't be different. If the screen name is different, it won't go to the screen. So it's capital story underscore 1. So that's what you need to do, story underscore 1. This is the screen's name, and you write story 2 and story 3 for the remaining two. Okay, so I did it. Here we have our 4 pieces of code ready. Now let's check what we need to do next. So here you go to the designer part once again, and then you go to the screen 2, or that's also known as story 1. We renamed it as story 1. So here what you need to do is drag and drop a web viewer, and for the story 2 screen also you do same thing, and even for the story 3 you drop this. And then what you need to do next is again go back to the story 1 screen, and you need to open your drive, and there you have some stories ready here. So what you need to do is when you click on the story will open in some time. So that story needs to go on to it as it is. So here I have the story, the line and the mouse. So here on the 3 dots you need to click, and you get an option to share. So here you need to change to anyone with the link, because it shouldn't be like only the one who has it. It can be anyone with the link, and then you copy the link here and done. And then you move to the code to play. Here in the home URL, you do control V, that's you paste it. And then for the story 2, you need to paste the second one and the third one respectively. Okay, so now I added the home URL for story 3, story 2, and for story 1. So now let's go back to the screen 1. And now what you need to do is, here you need to make the vertical arrangement to visible and vertical scroll arrangement to non-visible. So this is the first screen that a person will see. You can also click on screen 1, and here you can just change the title of the screen, or you can leave it blank. So I'm gonna leave it blank, so it's blank over here. So here what you need to do next is go to the blocks, go to story 1, and here what you need to do is, let's check here, and here you need to check for when screen 1 dot back pressed. So it's not supposed to be screen 1 backpress, but it's supposed to be story 1 backpress. So when story 1 dot backpressed, it should go to another screen. So open another screen. Screen name. So here the screen's name, it's going to be screen 1. Okay, so here we have screen 100, so it will go to that. So what you can do is, you can do right click, and you can just add it to backpack, and then go to screen story 2. Here from the backpack, you can bring the story 1 part and change it to story 2, and let the remaining part be the same. Then again you go to the story 3. And from the backpack, you bring one story 3 dot backpress, you should go to the screen 1. So this was our part of the programming. Now let's go to the designer interface. So here the story 3 is supposed to go to screen 1, the story time. And one thing you need to make sure is the vertical scroll arrangement is not visible currently. Okay, so this was our app known as Story Time. You can build it within 5 to 10 minutes. It's very easy. and now you can download it on your system. Thank you. Bye.